Hello YouTube, Terrell here with Big Time Nights, here to watch Entourage episodes 3 and 4 from season 2. And last episode, Eric finally broke up with his on and off girlfriend, which is good. They both cheated on each other, but she was going behind his back cheating the whole time while he was in New York being faithful. And you know, everyone knew she was trouble, you know, hard to deal with and everything. They never got along with her, and it took, you know, Eric a little more, you know, and finally, you know, he went through a lot, and she postponed it, a lot of, you know, meetups and all that kind of stuff, and he finally came to realization that, no, I'm out. I got a perfect 10 model over here. Let's do that. But anyways, we're just gonna get right into it. So make sure you guys watch your copy and then come over and watch my reaction. All right, guys, here we go.
Yeah, I remember back in the day, me and Kadeem Hardison and T.T. Howell used to sit at Hef's table, surrounded by playmates. They won't even let me in the joint.
You sat at Hugh Hefner's table?
Yeah, during the Melrose.
Rest in peace, Hugh Hefner. Man lived quite a life. My goodness.
Can I please advance 6 weeks' salary? What do you need $1,200 for? Just for these cashmere PJs, baby.
Turtle, my only cost $400.
You can go to the mansion in underoos and still get laid.
Yeah, you can go wrapped in barabots and still not get laid, Turtle. Put the fuck in pajamas.
I'm coming back for these, all right? Dude, feel how soft. Feel.
Barabots.
$1,200 for, like, a nightgown outfit. Fuck all that.
My mom just sold that house for $160,000. I'm getting a skylight.
Man, the housing prices that they're talking about is like nothing today.
Maybe this is a guest house?
Nothing. Going from living in a mansion to this, though, is a bit of a downgrade.
$1 million sure ain't what it used to be.
You're not kidding.
You can't be living in a dump like this.
This is $1 million? I think...
You have a pool, Vince.
Even if this was $1 million back then, how much do you think it is today? Like, it's got to be way more. Holy man. Housing is a mess. It really is.
I have a Spanish estate. Up outpost. It was Marlon Brando's old place.
Ooh, no, Brando.
It's in a slightly higher price range, though.
How slight? Don't worry about it. It's Brando's.
I'll set it up.
Susan's really happy about this.
Drama straightened out?
Oh, he's straightened out, right. He's banned for life. There's a better chance of the Pope in pajamas.
What? What'd he do?
The moron went to heaven.
Sue? Set all the chimps free.
Unbelievable.
One of the monkeys went
Siegfried and Roy on Miss August, and they said that she's lost out on becoming the Saturn National spokesperson because of the damage to her face.
Okay, look, I gotta go.
This is bullshit. Who's Machio?
The Karate Kid freed the monkeys?
I'm not kidding. I took him as my plus one.
Are we going to see the Karate Kid in this? That would have been an awesome show for me to react to, but I already been watching it. Ralph Macchio, yeah, he's been making quite a comeback with the Karate Kid. It's awesome. Or Cobra Kai.
We want you in the Warren family, Vince.
I'm all about family, John. In fact, after seeing your 200-foot yacht in last month's Rob report, can I call you Dad?
Vince.
Yeah.
Do you know how long Clint Eastwood's been with the studio?
No.
70 years. Yeah. We give him $90 million to make movies now. Does whatever he wants.
Isn't Clint Eastwood still making movies and he's like almost 100?
The point is, we don't micromanage our talent here.
No, they are very talent friendly.
Well, you know, I mean, this all sounds...
Like, his latest movie was like, what, a few years ago? I don't think it did so well, though.
Damn. Let's bring him a suit.
Bring in the suit.
What the fuck? Even Ari's. I hate the color purple too. Holy shit.
70-foot screen looking like an underwater Elton John.
Vinny, the suit will not...
Underwater Elton John.
It's just a prototype.
Yes.
All right. It's over. Do not mention this movie to me again. All right, now find me something else I can do.
That suit was ridiculous.
On Halloween, this guy goes dressed as himself.
Thank you, Turtle. You see, he knows me. Maybe I should let him be my manager.
Charge you 5%. This guy's ripping you off.
You know,
Turtle. Turtle's the yes man. Yes man. Don't be a yes man. It's not good for your friend.
I'll take it. Call Marv, have him start the paperwork.
You can't afford this house, Vince.
Can't afford anything we have. You never stopped me before. It's always worked out. Besides, we don't have time to house hunt. We gotta get a job.
Man, it must be so nice to be so, like, carefree and, you know, lackadaisical.
Hey, buddy.
Johnny Trauma.
Look at this guy. He's had a career resurgence, man.
The monkeys.
When were you at the Playboy Mansion, Ralph?
Oh, that was over 10 years ago, honey.
He looks so much younger here.
4-hour operation. Settlers in critical and stable condition. Normal after this type of operation. Her condition will be closely monitored for the next
second. Every time you try to
make sure that there are no signs of old.
Where are you going, Ari?
When you tried to creep, that's when you're the loudest. Stores be creaking.
Yeah, Playboy Mansion, strip clubs, whorehouses. I go where the meetings are. It's my fucking job.
I went 3 weeks in the south of France with the children.
Oh my god, baby. Of course you can go.
With you. And if you're not home by 2 a.m., I'm going to be standing at the gate screaming, Ari Gold, super agent for Gardens Viagra.
Sounds good.
I mean, she's happy. She's with a winner, so it's all good. I mean, like, Hugh's life, like Hugh Hefner, is interesting. It's like, just, like, you built up something where you're constantly surrounded by hot young women all the time. You know, like, it's crazy. I don't see anyone else really doing that. Like, even Kings, like, it wasn't like this, I would think. Not at all, no. Not at all. This is, like, unique.
I know you don't want to talk about it right now. I had an amazing meeting at Warner's.
Oh, Ari, please don't ruin the mansion.
You're going to want to hear this. Believe me.
You know what I want to hear? I want to hear what the love...
Do always have, like, multiple girlfriends at a time.
Look at them, listen to them, but what do you got? Sorry, what do you got for...
You never see that with in the opposite. Like, one woman and a lot of guys, there's different words for that.
Once the show is syndication, you gotta, like, find some tax deductions, you know? Vince, I'm telling you, real estate?
I heard this guy on the right, that 70 show guy, I thought, wasn't he one of the guys in Me Too? Like, he was, like, somewhat of a predator. I don't know the whole story, so maybe I shouldn't talk on it, but... I thought he was, like, guilty of some stuff.
But it was this guy that sprung the apes.
With all due respect, Mr. Hefner, I never went near that zoo. Never.
Well, you boys better remember who did. You're both out of here.
It was a long time ago.
We were so drunk.
We were sitting at that table by the grotto.
Yeah, we were banging out shots of Cuervo. And
it was me and you.
Holy! Let the fuck...
Pauly Shore. I liked a couple of his movies.
You know, the fucking get you from fucking
get him out of here.
Lifetime fan, Pauly.
Oh, bro.
Pauly did go to the mansion a lot, though.
He's a fucking buzzkill.
But I thought you don't need all the toys, Vince.
Yeah, I don't need them. I like them.
The worst thing that happens, they kick you out. They give me time to pack up your shit, bro. Trust me.
They ain't kicking us out, all right? Vince is a superstar. If it ain't this, it's something else.
MC Hammer could have used a guy like you, Turtle, back in the
day. Are these women, like, just working? Like, what's going on here?
Well, I don't know. Did you really hate the script?
No. I mean, I liked it. I just, you know, I don't want to end up looking like an idiot on the screen.
Wow. Never seen you this insecure.
I'm not...
Like, the women that go here, are like, are they all employed kind of by Playboy, or are they just, like, inviting hot women over and...
That you are a superhero.
I don't know.
They loved you so much in the meeting today, they want to shoot back-to-back movies like Lord of the Rings. That do anything for your confidence? They want to give you 5 for the first, 7 for the second, God willing, if there is a third, they want to give you 12. Boom!
That's like $50 million, Vince.
No, it's 12.
Yeah. It's honestly, it's nothing like the way superhero actors get paid like nowadays. Or maybe the heyday was mid-2010s. But wasn't Robert Downey Jr. getting like 50 mil for a movie? Or was it a contract of movies? Yeah, money changes your mind about certain things. Like, the ratio to women to men is like, 5 to 1 there. But that's why he gets to choose what guests go. Again, rest in peace. He, one of a kind.
You know the station agent, Eric?
Yeah.
Monster fucking hit at Sundance. Did you see it? It's about the midget who lives by the train tracks. The last time I saw him, he was in a FedEx commercial. They were overnighting him to London.
His name is Peter Dinklage, all right? He's doing a movie with Vin Diesel right now.
Really? Which one is it? The Twins Park Dude?
You'll never give me credit for anything, will you?
Peter Dinklage? Okay, now I know that reference. Because this was before Game of Thrones. So he was on the rise. Okay.
Dr. Green?
Yeah.
He's good.
The best.
Johnny Chase?
I'm just getting my girlfriend something.
You have a girlfriend?
Yeah.
That's too bad.
Damn. That's a look of regret right there.
Well, Doc, I've always felt top heavy.
Damn, these doctors are rolling in it for elective surgeries. Like, holy crap, man. Nowadays, like, with the Instagram boom, it's even more so.
Doc, I'm an actor by trade. My legs are my livelihood.
You want to get implants in your legs, though, for calves? Like, fuck all that, man.
Echoes, it's just my calves I can't live with. Yeah.
Such a waste. But I have, like, really good calf genetics, and I work out with them a lot, so they're very, like... very nice. But getting surgery for it is wild. Getting surgery, elective surgery for anything, especially as a dude. Like, if you're a normal dude, just work out.
Brad and Jen's master bath. Heartbreaking. Although, I heard they might be getting back together.
Hey, Cal, you have any pictures of Jen in the tub?
This show does show his age with certain references, though. Brad and Jen.
You take a check?
Of course.
Actually, we're a little low on cash flow right now. Maybe...
Yeah, we're waiting for some money to come in.
Big money, Carrie. You're doing Aquaman's house.
Ooh, fancy. Hey, ooh, we should get you guys an aquarium then. I know the best place.
Oh my god, you're just adding to it.
Come on, Chris, we had a deal. Don't make me beg.
What do you need this money for? You in trouble?
No, it's nothing like that. Selective surgery.
What, are you getting your nose done?
No, implants. Calf implants.
You're sicker than I thought.
Yeah.
It is common.
You know, Vince, Oscar De La Hoya has a shop in his house. Ah, man, should I have one of his?
Yeah. How much, Keith?
Well, that guy right there is $6,500.
Man, like, the upkeep for, like, taking care of an aquarium, like, even a mini aquarium, it's gotta cost so much. Like, what the hell? So much work. You gotta keep refiltering water and everything. Fighting without helmets, though? You're an actor, drama. You can't be taking blows like this.
This is my life.
Hey, these things are gonna feel like fake tits.
Look, I'm on the moon, Turtle.
Oh, I'm just asking a question. You think girls sit around like us? Are you like a guy with real calves or fake calves?
As long as you go underneath the muscle, like with tits, they have a natural feel.
So you felt a man's fake calf before?
Hell.
Oh, listen, Johnny. I'll think about it.
Johnny needs to get off of this. Like, it's crazy. It really is.
Yeah?
You know I love you, right, bro?
But I know. I understand the feeling when you have a one-track mind of getting something, you really want it. But sometimes, hopefully, you wise up.
Hey, Sundance, baby, we did it.
Don't forget, Josh Weinstein's the one that found you that script.
We remember.
Great. This is my girl, Ema. Did 3 episodes of North Shore last year. We're moving in together. Might even buy the same couch as you.
Why is she biting her lip and looking like that?
Okay, baby, go check out
like
the lamp, okay? Seriously.
Nice to meet you.
That was weird. He pats her on the head like a fucking dog.
Do you know how many times I've told him I'm Chinese? The man does not listen.
Lloyd, listen, I don't care if he's in the middle of open heart surgery. Get him on the phone.
Okay, fine, E. But it's just because you are...
Oh my God, Lloyd, just get him on the phone.
I would have to say it's his anger. I mean, he goes from 0 to 100 in a second flight.
Come on.
Do you feel this is an accurate assessment?
No, I'm a very calm guy. I mean, whether it's that...
I love the pause because it's so realistic.
At work or in a social situation.
Like when his wife does that little petty laugh.
Who I love very dearly. She likes to nag and I react to the nagging.
Overreact.
She knows how to push his buttons, man. She really does. It's really good acting. Good chemistry too.
Ari? I told you to turn it off.
I did turn it off, but this is the emergency line. This is the bat line, baby.
Do you need to get that?
I do need to take this, yes.
No, he doesn't. I asked for 1 hour out of a day for his undivided attention. And I can't even have that?
You can have it if you want to live in Agoura fucking Hills and go to group therapy. But if you want a Beverly Hills mansion and you want a country club membership and you want 9 weeks a year and a Tuscan villa, then I'm going to need to take a call when it comes in at noon on a motherfucking Wednesday.
See, that's it. There it is.
You know what? I have to take this.
I mean, he's right. He has an answer.
James Cameron is not it. Dana Gordon is not it.
Mm-hmm.
Peter Cole covers
who?
Peter Cole.
Where's Mr. Cole's fucking office?
That way.
Call Gordon and Cameron every 5 minutes until someone picks up. Cole, where's...
Man, being Ari's assistant is gotta be rough.
Right here?
James Cameron is directing Aquaman.
That's great. That's awesome.
That's awesome, huh? You didn't think to bring it up in the fucking staff meeting? An email?
No,
a yellow fucking sticky something?
I didn't know I was supposed to know that kind of stuff.
Well, what is it you're supposed to know, do you think, huh?
What
the fuck do we pay you for? To get your agency card laminated so you can go to shelter and try to fuck Misha Barton?
I didn't think...
Let me tell you something. You don't have to say anything. You know why? Because you pick up all your stuff because you're motherfucking fired.
What happened?
I don't know. I was dropping off Peter's mail and then Mr. Gold fired me. My life is over.
Oh my God, that was awesome. Ari's epic rants.
Is it true?
Ari, listen, I couldn't say anything.
The actor does such a good job in this role. Holy crap, man. Jeremy Piven is awesome.
Who got you that job? Who pulled you out of accounting?
Okay, Ari, listen to me, all right?
He's too good at it. He probably is getting typecast. I don't really see him in much other stuff.
Hey, Vince. I want to tell these cunts that I'm with you.
Is this guy with you, Vince?
This guy's gonna win Sundance for the second time this year. Billy Walsh, you don't know him?
Well, alrighty then.
Let's walk.
Enjoy your evening.
By the way, don't call me cunt. I don't care who you are. Calm down with that.
Hey, skirt suit. Whoa, would you? Let me get in next to the models.
Hey, asshole.
Billy.
Yo, am I gonna be happy with myself to be cut? Happiness is a state of mind, Johnny. Now, let me get your place. I like your girl better, okay? You hear anything?
Okay, Walsh. Calm down, man. He's going a little too hard with this, with the disrespect.
You see this guy right here? See that guy right there? Nobody believed in them. I did, and it paid off.
We believed in you, Vince, and that really paid off, baby.
The Sundance FBI!
Thank you.
Yo, Eric. You guys want to move on down? It seems a little crowded. You can take over Leo's table.
Wait, he's not coming in?
No, Leo went to Paris to talk to James Cameron about some fish movie.
We are so fucked.
Ain't no way Leo is doing a superhero flick. Even nowadays, I just don't see him. Doesn't seem like his type of film. It took him, even back then, this time, he didn't have an Oscar yet. It took him all these years to get one. It's crazy. Solid episodes of Entourage. We got to see, you know, Ari epic rant or epic blow up. His acting in this episode was really good. Oh my god! You could see the chemistry with him and his wife. Like her little side remarks and how they like really piss him off and get under his skin and the pauses. That was excellent because I could really see that happen. Some people know what to say to tick you off a little bit. And I couldn't completely relate to that. Not saying that happens to me, but I could see, you know, it's happened to everyone. You guys know what it is. But anyways, solid episodes. Thank you for watching Big Time Nights. Until next time, peace.